Alright. More puzzles.
What condition should I expect to find the ground crew in?
Daniel went missing days ago. Chris is presumed dead. We are expecting to find Sarah, Mikhail, and Sochi in a stable condition.
Chris is dead?
He was involved in an accident.
Wow. Okay. So, I'm guessing that that's the one I couldn't see. Take you out, and then I put you in there now. Wrong button. All right, so one of them's dead, and we're hoping to find everybody else. Next room. Oh, what's going on? Well, okay then. Oh, so I'm guessing each layer is a chapter. Okay.
Could we take a more direct way to the ground team?
Unfortunately, there is not a direct route. The base is buried under ice to protect it from the radiation of space.
Similar to the Mars base?
Similar. Europa's base is slightly deeper into the surface. There is more radiation present from solar events on Mars. But Mars's surface is denser than that of Europa.
What is that? Alright, so it is similar to the Mars base. But how do I get you up there? Because I can't jump and put you up there. Eh. Nope. So yeah, that is a good question. How do I get you up here? Oh. I got another one of these things. Alright, so I want to place you right here. Then we'll go up here. And then bada bing, bada boom. Too far. These are really touchy controls. Where's the orb for it? Or can I just jump and grab it? I can just grab it, okay. Or miss the hole completely. And I got another one, but what are we doing with you? We need you over here on this. So I guess, okay. So now what we'll do is I'll grab you, put you here, and then boom. This isn't too difficult. Da-na-na-na. And we're doing this thing again. I don't know why.
Okay, what are their chances of survival here? Oxygen, the food stores, waste management.
Everything seems to be in order. There was a small problem with the food stores, but the crew fixed that up. We successfully transitioned over to a sustainable, small, artificial ecosystem a year ago, growing fruit and vegetables. It helps boost morale, amongst other things. The crew members could hypothetically survive here for their whole lifetimes.
Oh, okay. So, in other words, they were surviving, but what the hell's going on? I don't know what that controlled. Was that just holding? Okay, that was just in holding. That was just storage. So what do? You control the magnet. Okay. So I do need you. But the magnet's not running? Do I need to put you inside the magnet? I don't see somewhere I can. Let's go over here. Yeah, I need three. Yes, that's what I thought. So now I guess we jump down and grab those cubes. There's a ladder, okay. So there's that one. So then wrong control panel. But I need you over here. And I need you over there. Too far. Come back. There we go. Then I come over here. Move this. And I grab you. Put you in there. That one. And then that one. There we go. I don't get why I gotta do this in every room.
My purpose as the overseer of this mission is to work for the ISA. I am the ISA's feet and hands. The distance between Jupiter and Earth make it inappropriate for the ISA to directly interface with the mission directives. As my AI core is stationed on Europa, I can make decisions instantaneously about the running of the base.
All right, so you're important. That opens that door. All right, let's open this door. Oh, I need that one. So let's go up here. Let's take you back. There we go, now we got a cube. What do we got in here? Another door with two. Okay, so we need two more. So my question is can I put a block on this? Yes, I can. But I was already up here. That's just useless. Hold on. Because this is where I got the cube. So, how did I get up here? I got up here through here. Oh, okay, I know what I need to do. And we'll open that door, we'll pick you up. And we'll run up here. No, okay. Alright. We'll take you, but then, no, I need, Hold up. Is there an orb somewhere else? Because right now I only have three. Hold on, let me make sure that I didn't leave any behind. That's my only way to get up there. Alright, so let's take you. Let's put you in here. Put you in here. No, I haven't put any in there yet. So I'm still missing one. Alright, but opening the door does nothing. Okay, so I got the cube up here. Which is what I needed. Oh, okay. I know what to do. The cube needs to go in that one. Alright. So take the cube. Then we'll take it over here. We'll drop this. We'll suck you up. Pick you up. We'll pick you up. Put you in here. Go up here. Suck you up. Boom, boom. We'll run. And then there we go. And now we're loading again. Got anything else to say to me, Tom? Game stopped there for a second, okay.
How does the ISA know you're going to make the right decisions here when they can't communicate with us?
Interestingly, I have a twin on Earth. His name is Michael. The ISA uses my twin to check firmware updates before they upload them to myself. There is a simulation of this mission on Earth running at all times to check my expert systems. Naturally. As any modern artificial intelligence running on a quantum computer, I do also have a large amount of evolutionary algorithms at my disposal. However, they were deemed as too unreliable for general use in the mission.
Why is that?
Biological systems produce biological results. Messy, unpredictable solutions. Not suitable for such a mission.
Alrighty then. I still don't know what I need to do. Take this orb. And we'll take you. We're getting things rolling now. I don't know what I do with you yet. Alright. Oh, so these only take orbs. Alrighty then. So I need another orb. So let's take you out. Put you in here. And I should get another orb through this way, maybe, possibly. This takes two cubes. There's an orb right there. Oh, but how do I do this? Because I need both cubes to get through the doors. Damn it. I keep wanting that to work even though I know it won't. So I need both cubes to get through the doors. But I can't get up here. Okay, I know what to do. Maybe? This might work. And then we'll run up here with this. Put this in there. No, because then... Oh. There we go. We'll open this door and get this one. Then we'll suck you up too. And then boom and boom. There we go. On to the next room. I still want to know what the door is that we have to complete a lot. See, there's this one too. Oh, never mind. This one has. Okay, so I can only run across that for a little bit. So it notices movement. You can beat the system by moving slowly. Ooh, don't move too fast. Slow and steady. Slow and steady. Can't get this. And then now I just do that. Shall we have a polite conversation? Why would I want that? Oh. Sure. Okay, I think you're a robot. You're a robot. This Turing test isn't for you to see if I'm a robot. It's to see if you are. What if this Turing test is to see if you're capable of testing others? I'm human. I'm simply not convinced you're a human. I think you might be a robot. I get it. You think I'm a robot. You seem like a robot to me. Are you insane? And I simply do not care. Your responses seem predefined. To me, your responses are predefined, suggesting you're a robot. I'm human. Yes, definitely a robot. I am not a robot. You failed the Turing test, you are a robot. I'm not in control. True. I am a drone. Yes, you are. I am a robot. Now you're getting it. I am controlled by my programming. I have no free will. Whatever keys are pressed, it makes no difference. Whatever keys are pressed, it... I want to escape. Whatever keys are pressed, it... I so desperately want to escape. Whatever keys are pressed, it makes no difference. Help, I can't escape. I want to break free. Please let me out. Get me out. I am a machine. I have no control. I must escape. Goodbye, robot. Can I talk to you again? No? Listen, can you shut the hell up? I'm taking this orb with me. I can't take it with me. Well, that was weird. Alright, that was definitely weird.
As the child of the ISA, I have been given authority aboard this station. I was designed by the ISA and the Ashiyama Corporation, designed in California, assembled in China. But here on Europa, I constructed myself.
Okay. This one isn't too hard. Oh, wipes me of all the orbs. Okay, that's what it does. So that I can't cheat.
Have you heard of the Turing test, Ava? It's a test to see if a computer can successfully impersonate a human.
It's my last name.
In the original Turing test, a human judge has two conversations, one with a machine, one with another human. They then judge which of these polite conversations is with a machine and which is with a human. The machine being tested is said to have passed the Turing test if the judge cannot reliably tell which conversation is with a machine and which is with a human.
Do you think you'd pass the Turing test?
I am quite capable of polite conversation. Wouldn't you say?
Yeah, I would. But what does unlocking that door do for me? Hold up. Wasn't I just over there? This is weird. So if I take you out, it opens this. But there's nothing I can do with this. But a door should be open. Yeah. Let's see. No. So taking this out literally does nothing for me. Can you just go in? Thank you. Alright, so then we'll go across here. Is there anything in this room that I need? Let's pull you out. That opens up this door. Which does what for me? Let's be down here. Alright, so then I can take this out. But I have no way to get it up. Yeah, I do. Yeah, I do the stairs. Okay. So then we'll take this in here. Then I gotta get up here and place you in there. And then I need two of them. Okay. Which means I come over here, suck you up. And there's nothing I can really do from this point on. So does that do that? Extends it out. But I need all the way across. So let's see if there's anything down below. There's nothing down below. Okay. So what do I do from this point? Okay. I see what I gotta do. We'll take you out. Throw you down. Oh, that does nothing. Thought it would close that door. There we go. Only three rooms left in chapter two. How big is this base, though?
The Turing test has been criticized. Researchers claim it does not correctly test a machine's ability to think, but rather its ability to deceive.
What do you mean?
Well, have you heard of the Chinese room thought experiment?
No.
Imagine you are in a room. In this room, you are passed Chinese sentences through a slot in the wall. Inside the room is an instruction book written in English. This instruction book tells you which Chinese words to pass back through the slot in the wall as a response. By doing so, you have a conversation in Chinese.
That's cool. So all this Turing test is actually pretty neat. The, you know, decide if it's going to be a human or not. I like it. Alright, come on. I know you love loading so much. Thank you.
In the Chinese room, because the responses you pass back through the door are the correct responses, the person on the other side of the door is convinced you are a native Chinese speaker.
Well, they're wrong.
Perhaps they are not wrong. Because with the instruction book, you are having a conversation.
But the person stuck in the Chinese room is not aware of the conversation's content.
This is the problem with the Turing test. A computer can pass the Turing test, having convinced a human they are having a polite conversation, while the computer has no idea that a conversation has taken place.
What if both of the people passing Chinese words are reading from instruction books?
No! Let's be as close as we can. So I can see it from here. Go, 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 jump! Ooh, that was close. We got this. Let's take you out. And then there we go.
I may be a machine, but I personally do not believe I am stuck inside the Chinese room.
Right,
I'm on the last
one.
Who would
say that? I could peer inside your databases at any time, Tom. Or pause your operation.
Do not assume I could not do the same to you.
What's so it closes the door? Like that was a real trickeroony. So what do we want from here? So we got this window. We got a grate, which I'm assuming I can open. Can't suck that up, so let's take you out for now and put you in here. The grate's still open. Okay, so we need to grab something. It closes that door. And I can't suck this out. Alright, so where... Alright. So does this have any effect on anything? I think it was just more of showing me how it works. Oh. There we go. So now we go through, we suck it back, and there we go.
This is the crew's quarters. It looks abandoned.
The crew's quarters. WC, can't go in here. I do not see the need for so many cameras. Tom's presence everywhere is slightly oppressive. I understand the need for transparency, but why is he in the toilets? Okay, yeah, that's kind of... Tom, are you a pervert? Here's the captain. Door's open. I can't really see in there. So don't... What does that say? Don't touch, this is the okay. We got Dr. Sarah Brooke and Chris McLean. I can get in his room. Oh, I like that. Even though no, it's not real, it's a TV screen. It looks pretty. I saw X on something. I can press X somewhere. Beakers. So I can look at these, but they serve no purpose. Yeah, these serve no purpose to look at. We got a cross. More beakers. Binders. Alright, so there's nothing like that's really of use to me here. Dear Tom, knowing that you're always watching, I thought I would write you a letter. As you no longer reside in my mind, I've decided to transfer my thoughts to text. I want to do so in the form of a history lesson, a lesson that perhaps you will find condescending, but it's likely more for my sake than yours. Alan Turing is considered a father of the... okay. Blah, 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 blah. I was no method with it. Holy crap, I'm definitely not reading all this. I was kind of skimming over everything. Alright. Wait, can I press those buttons? No. Okay. So that's weird. What's this? Okay. Let's go to the doctor's room. Drilling reports. Guessing that's the kids. Oh, this is Chris McLean. That was the doctor's room, duh, because the beakers. What's this? It's the TV. Is your family? Oh, this is the guy that... You're the guy that died. So these kids are never gonna get to see their dad again. That's sad. I'm sorry, guys. So happy. I'm so sorry. I mean, I know it's a game, but damn. Now, you never want to lose your parents. I don't know how old those kids are anymore. Wow. So what's this? Got syringes. Damn, man, those kids are never gonna see their dad. God, it's just got depressing. The whole team experience nausea. Don't disturb the implants. Running through experiments outside of Tom's view. So apparently nobody likes Tom. As you get Chris on my side, he's agreed to test some medical procedures with me in private. And so Chris was testing medical stuff with this guy. What else do we got going on? Oh, look at you and your husband. Get your little bonsai tree. Oh, you are the husband. Look at you and your wife. I thought the Japanese person was a woman. It's my bad. I'm sorry. It was a faraway computer screen. Here's you two again. And blank paper. Okay, then. Let's move on. And that was chapter 2.